Our relaxed leather-wrapped albums will appeal to your customers looking for something special and unique. These albums are made with soft leather wrapped around hand-torn or straight-cut pages in a variety of paper choices. Each album is handcrafted with each signature stitched into the soft premium top-grade leather cover. Casual, yet sophisticated, at a price you won't believe.
Shooting with a light that Weston, my hubby, made for us, and it's to simulate ring flash was originally why he made it, but I think it's almost so much better than that. It gives kind of like a cinema quality or something just totally different than the average portrait studio. So
yeah, it's really unique. Very nice.
Okay, so let's get going. So I'm thinking we'll just start even with you. We've got her in kind of this more editorial, fun outfit, which is what Kimmy and I just love to shoot just for fun sometimes. And then sometimes our clients, even though it's not what we push, it's not necessarily boudoir, sometimes our clients will want to come in for a second shoot and do something that's a little bit wacky, kind of editorial. So this is Sarah. And Sarah, I'm going to have you start off by just holding this and having your arm locked. Hopefully your arm can reach like that. And then just a really, like, yeah, exactly what you're doing. That's pretty much it. Yeah, that's more like it. 160 shutter at 2.8. So perfect. I just want you to kind of look over there for me. Gorgeous. And I'm actually shooting to get the backlight in there. I love the way that looks, especially when we throw filters on it later. Gorgeous. And then just eyes kind of over at me. Perfect. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. I love it. A little bit more. So cute. Perfect. Okay, now I'm going to come in and get some close-up stuff. So I kind of want you know what? I still like this, but bring that hand up and kind of pull it in your hair. Yeah, exactly. Gorgeous. Good expression. Oh my gosh, looks amazing. I brought my light closer, so I'm just adjusting my exposure now. I like to have it overexposed, but that was a little too much. Beautiful. Looks so awesome. Now just keep looking through this light, like kind of at the mirror over there. And when we backlight with those lights, sometimes it can be hard to focus on her eyes. But if we just play with it a little bit, we'll eventually get it. Gorgeous. Good job holding it. Love it. Keep looking over there for me. And now just eyes right here. Cute. Okay, so now I'm going to have you seated just right here. You're going to be straight at the camera, just knees forward and kind of like tipped like this. And it's all going to be about like the rings and the fun hair and your accessories and stuff.
With every shoot that we do, we always want to make sure that our clients' hands are engaged somehow in the shot. So it's not just limp hands. You always want something engaged.
She's got the fun, dramatic attitude to go with this.
Turn your rings into your face a little bit more, a little bit less.
Sarah's worked with us a few times, so she knows what we're looking for.
Yeah, you can tell, huh?
Most clients, it's not this easy.
Beautiful. And eyes kind of low for a sec. Love it. Stay just like that. Keep looking like right here. When we have them bring their eyes right at the light, it just makes them sparkle so much. And then eyes at me again. Oh my gosh, crazy about it. Stay right there. Beautiful. So cute. So cute. Okay, I'm going to get full body. Kind of pull the light to the side angle, which works too. We don't always have to shoot through it. I'm going to stand you up for a sec, Sarah, actually. So with this kind of a shoot, it's more just about showing off like the fun, funky outfit than necessarily like a boudoir shoot where we're posing simply to show off our body.
Do you want my arms like this?
The other way, I think.
And does the boudoir shoot sometimes turn into this? Because
you can see that side of them coming out. Mm-hmm. So you end up with an add-on. Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of the time when we sell our supermodel shoot is because people want maybe the last set to be fun and funky like this.
We also want to make sure that our inspiration is coming from the fashion world and in our boudoir shoots in general. So in the sets that we use and then the lights that we use and the poses and even styling, we want to make sure we're staying current with what's going on in the magazines and the editorials and things like Vogue and W Magazine.
It's probably important to your clients that want this kind of shoot too.
Mm-hmm. You know what? I want that backlight in there a little bit more, so I'm going to have you step that direction like a foot. Yeah, I just want to get this shot with.
I love how you leave some of the hardware in also. You know, I mean, the backlight, the actual light and everything, it's just, it makes it look like it's right out of a magazine. Mm.
That's exactly what we're hoping for. We don't want it to be just the flat, plain backdrop and then our subject in front of it. We want to have a lot of different dimensions and different elements.
This just kind of gives a glimpse of what went on,
too. It's true. Kind of a behind the scenes look. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Pretty. Okay, so now we're going to totally switch it, and let's put the light behind you. And so the light's just going to spill kind of around her, and it's just going to be really moody and different.
And again, thinking of an album, the finished product, with a client, she's going to choose one of the images that Marissa has shot before, and now something else like this side by side would just look awesome in the album spread.
Oh, yeah.
So that's what we're doing here.
So here's something like this, like just turning the lights around. It's a whole different look and a whole new photo for her to add. So we want to try and find little ways to tweak the whole set by just doing something really quick. So maybe, just hands on your hips. Beautiful. So now I'm really going to overexpose to get that light that's wrapping around her face. So I'm just guessing right now.
Pop more. There you go.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, it looks so fun. I need to overexpose a little bit more. Doing good, Sarah. Love it. So cute. Keep it up. Keep looking in the mirror in front of you. So cute.
Everybody needs a Sarah to walk through their door.
Inspiration.
She's our muse. She's our muse.
Gorgeous. Up and see, this is something I don't want to Photoshop out later. Got it. Wait, no, this looks cute too.
So where did you get this light?
Well, Weston built it. He just kind of envisioned something and went for it. So he just put together 4 fluorescent lights on a stand, yeah.
Wow. It's a rolling stand. All of our lights, it's easier if they're on rollers, so we can move them from set to set just to make it easier.
That was perfect how it was in front of her, and then you just
light it right behind.
Yep.
Yeah.
So what do we have going on here?
So this is our hallway that we actually usually have canvas prints hanging down this hallway. So we take them out and kind of just shows how you can utilize a small space and just make something happen with the small spaces that you have. So this is called our runway set, and it's just going to be a lot of movement, really fun. I'm going to make Sarah kind of play with her skirt a little bit and do her catwalk little runway move. So. Yeah, it's just kind of a fun addition.
And you're lighting from the back and from the front.
And from the front, yeah. Okay. We'll probably do a few different things, but this is our main light here. Great. Again. Yeah. That's it.
Okay.
You ready? Okay, here we go. And go ahead and look just past me. Strut there. And then I really want you to exaggerate doing this
of that.
So fun. And pause right there. Strut it. There you go. Nice. We'll be right back. tail shot, so I want to get just her legs. It's always a great shot for an album. Especially with that reflection, it's fun to show that off. And then scooting a little bit closer. Great, the tip out a little bit more. Perfect, just like that. Love that. Okay, got it. Fun. Dirty mirror and all.
So right now up on the screen, we have all our images out of Lightroom. So as you can see, we've got a pretty big variety going on in here. So now we're going to open one of these up in Photoshop and show you guys kind of how we would finish it.
Let's go with this one. These are just straight out of Lightroom. We've used our presets. And with the lighting that we use, you really don't need to do too much else to this image. So all I'm going to do is run portraiture and then use our perfect boudoir action. And then it'll be good to go and it'll be perfect for her album. So I've just run our perfect boudoir action, and now I have the two layers that we're going to be working with. The first one is our color layer. When I take it away, you can see the image as it was before and then with the action. And it's just a little bit too intense on this image, especially on her hair, I'm noticing, because it's sort of losing a little bit of detail in the darkness of her hair because it is such a richness in color that it's adding. So I'm going to take that away.
I especially love what it does to the eyes and the lips. That's my favorite part about
this color layer. Yeah, action. Look at how much more vibrant her eyes are. So let's just go ahead and use the brush tool. I'm going to use my black brush at probably a 70% opacity on this brush. And it's a soft brush so that we don't see any hard edges as we're taking away the color. And I'm just going to brush over her hair to sort of bring back in what it looked like before, so that we can still see the detail in these dark shadows of her hair. The other area I might take it away, however, is down here in this lower corner, because it, again, is adding a little bit too much darkness. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to pull that back through, still on my brush tool and still working on this layer mask. So that's about right for the color. Now I'm going to drop down to the next layer, which is the airbrushing layer. And I'm going to zoom in nice and close and see where I might want to add a little bit more airbrushing to her skin. So still with my brush tool, I'm going to switch to the white color. And opacity, we usually brush at about 90% opacity for the airbrushing layer. A little bit on the nose. And I never want to go over details and lines, so I don't want to go over her nose completely, and I certainly don't want to go over her lips with this layer. If I do on accident, I just switch my brush tool back to the black and bring that layer back in, because I want to make sure that those details are nice and sharp and it doesn't look like we've made her plastic. That's about right. I'm going to flip back to how it looked like before, and then now with the finished little touching that we add. So we only like to spend just a couple minutes on each image that is going to be in an album. We don't want to spend hours upon hours at this stage, because that's going to lose us money in the end. So we process quickly and make a high quality image for a product that she's going to love.
As quickly as possible.
As quickly as possible. And that's how we do it.